Melbourne is booming, with its population on track to overtake Sydney as Australia's biggest city in the next few decades. From humble beginnings, it's been meticulously transformed into what we all know is the best city in the world. Now, Peter Mitchell takes you inside the place we call home.
Melbourne. Rapidly growing and ever-changing. The nation's multicultural, hospitality and sporting heart.
It's phenomenal, a century of growth.
I love Melbourne. I wouldn't live it anywhere in the world. It's the best city.
Melbourne is the fastest growing city in Australia. By 2056, it could reach 9 million residents and become the nation's biggest city. And this is its changing face.
The fastest growing city in Australia at the moment. And, you know, while one in four Australians lives in Victoria, three quarters of them live right in Melbourne.
I've watched Melbourne grow up, and it's a city I love.
As a proud Victorian, I've lived and worked here all my life. I've seen Melbourne transform from a place where the shops were shut on Sundays, thank you, to the lofty title now of the world's most livable city.
Melbourne has got such beautiful restaurants, beautiful art centres, beautiful culture, and we do everything, football.
But that's nothing compared to what the next 30 years are going to bring. The many suburbs and tribes that make up Victoria's capital are evolving in ways our grandparents could never have predicted.
We've developed a street life that's the envy of the world.
You've got the cafe culture, you've got the cultural capital being Melbourne, and of course sport is part of the DNA of this city.
Melbourne's 180 years old and has made a remarkable transformation. Our love of sport and all things cultural have become part of who we are as a modern city, with an increasing urban sprawl.
More than half of all new housing approvals are in the medium or high density housing. And so the future actually will be for the vertical communities rather than just that horizontal sprawl of the past. That's the future of Melbourne living.
Compared to the rest of Australia, Melbourne has a young population. Our smartest suburb is Parkville, while people in East Melbourne have the city's highest incomes. The residents of Sandhurst, near Carrum Downs, prefer married life to those in Carlton. The motor car is king in the west. Plumpton residents near Caroline Springs have 2.6 cars per household.
If there's one thing that makes this city so rich, it has to be our cultural diversity. From the gold rush right through post-World War II until now, immigration has been responsible for Melbourne's beating heart.
It's a beautiful street. We made the street. The Italian made the street.
The city's Vietnamese embrace Springvale, the Chinese, Box Hill and Carlton, and the Turkish, Dallas. Our biggest Indian population is in Dandenong. Afghans, like Dandenong South, a big Greek community calls Clarinda near Oakley home, while it's Little Italy in Pasco Vale.
Well, Melbourne really is a little United Nations.
And our city is home to many different religions. Followers of Islam reside in Dallas, the Catholics in Avondale Heights, Buddhists in Sunshine. Culturally diverse, vibrant, and picture perfect, Melbourne has a very bright future.